All right, Dauntless Onslaught is excellent. Observant Alcide is also really good, but Dauntless Onslaught is just better most of the time. Stone Shock Giant's also not bad, and we're a little on the low end of the curve right now, so I wouldn't mind getting a couple like five drops to go so when the game goes long. But we'll just take the really good trick. All right, Heliod's Emissary is by far the best of the emissaries, I think. I guess the blue one's close, but Heliod's Emissary is really good. It's like definitely the best one to play just as a 4-mana creature. Like a 4-mana 3/3 that taps their guy when it attacks is fantastic. And then the bestow mode is obviously insane. So that's easily the pick. Hopefully we wheel this Lagana Band Elder. They haven't been wheeling so far. The Dragon Mantle might wheel, but I don't actually know if we want a third one. Well, we probably do, but there's a chance we don't. Really don't want to play a second Battlewise Valor when we also have a Dauntless Onslaught and a God's Willing already. I kind of just want to take this 5-mana 3/2 flyer. It's not great when you can't activate the ability, though. I guess I'll take a second Battlewise Valor. It's pretty unlikely that either makes the cut, to be honest. It's too bad there's like three quality blue cards in this pack. Alright, well, Battlewise Valor it is, I suppose. Alright. Yeah, Arena Athlete's probably just better than a Crone Crusader. The Crusader's not that bad, actually. But we're gonna be heavier white than red, so Arena Athlete has a higher impact later in the game. Oh wow. This is a gift of a pack. We have Labyrinth Champion, who's excellent. Evangel of Heliod, who is also excellent. I'm gonna count our enablers to see how good Labyrinth Champion's gonna be. It seems like it's gonna be really good. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, maybe probably not going to make the cut. Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Eight. Yeah, we have a lot of enablers for Labyrinth Champion. And there are some decks where this card just goes to town on their creatures. Cavalry Pegasus would even I'd be a card I'd be happy to play in this deck, but I'm going to take the champion for sure. All right, there's another good enabler and chosen by Heliod. Basically, always happy to play that card. And I don't think we need creatures so badly that I want to take Traveling Philosopher yet. I guess we'll keep choosing by Heliod. Hopefully that means we can start cutting the Dragon Mantles and moving our mana base more towards like the 10/7 that I wanted. Jeez, I don't want a fourth chosen by Heliod, really, but I don't really want either of these red cards either, so I guess I'll take it. Heliod definitely is going to be choosing a lot of our people. I don't want another portent. I guess I'll take this 1/4. I don't know what deck you side in a 1/4 against, but if it's out there, we will be prepared. Well, our Labyrinth Champion is going to be completely insane. Lagana Band is easily the pick here. Creature I'm happy to start. I'd like to cut these Cerberuses if possible. And I think I'm probably going to cut Anger of the Gods, although with the Chosen by Heliod, it's actually kind of good in our deck. So maybe it stays in. All right, 5-mana flying dude. It's not terrible. We have a lot of cards to build with here. What does the fox say? Good old 5-mana 3/5. Probably better than the griffin, actually. All things considered. All right, so deck building time. These ones are all for sure. I'm not sure about 4 chosen by Heliods. It might be a little excessive. We'll see. Those are the red cards I really want to play, and then I'm fine playing like these other five. But this is 23 cards now. I'm also not unhappy to play Anvil Rot Raptor, but not happy about it either. So our curve is super low right now. Let's look at it. Hopeful Eidolon's really going to be a 4-drop, because you never cast this as a 1-mana 1-1. It's just terrible in that mode. This is like all enablers. This is really creature light right now, so I'm not thrilled with that. Like, these are really bad if you don't have a creature to put on them. I'm also happy to earn 16 lands because we have 4 cantrips. So I'd like to add some creatures. I'm going to add the Anvil Rot Raptor. And I think I want to just play Silent Artisan. I think I'm also going to cut, like, one of the Chosen by Heliods for a Dragon Mantle, because I'd rather draw, like, one of each. Putting Dragon Mantle on a Chosen by Heliod guy is actually pretty good. So I think I also don't want this Battlewise Valor. Just too many tricks at that point. Too many, like, I don't want to draw a hand that's all tricks, no creatures. And this is only 12 creatures because this doesn't count. So if we play this, we have 4 cantrips in our deck, 16 lands. It should be fine. Wouldn't mind finding a way to get another creature in, actually. Probably, like, the Griffin. Right now I think we're doing a 10-6 mana base, probably. Yeah, that sounds right. No, 9-7 should be okay. Yeah, 9-7 should be fine. No, maybe 12 creatures is enough. Hopefully it is. We'll find out. 12-4, I don't think so. Because this is also really a red card, actually. Maybe 7 is too many. Yes, I think 10-6 should be fine. Our Dragon Mantle's, like, not going to be great, but it only really needs... If it pumps +2/+0, or, like, the threat of +2/+0, that's usually pretty strong. Alright, let's give this a whirl. We'll see how it goes.